हेलो स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ पीयूष माथुर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, आर्या कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी, खोकस, जयपुर। माई वीडियो लेक्चर इज बेस्ड ऑन सब्जेक्ट यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर एंड टुडे माई टॉपिक इज यूनिट नंबर 5 अकॉर्डिंग टू आरटीयू सिलेबस, स्पीड टाइम कर्व फॉर द ट्रैक्शन सिस्टम। In previous lecture, we had studied about the different type of traction system and track electrification of system. For the traction system, make a good traction system, must be analysis of speed time curve. So we have decided. So first of all, we talk about the speed time curve. If we take x-axis on time and y-axis is speed, therefore the curve between them, this is called speed time curve. In speed time curve, speed in kilometer per hour and time in second. So for in general traction view point of view, we see in this diagram there is a graph of speed time curve. So there is a many point O, starting point O, then next point A, B, C, D, and E. When we given to the supply to motor by the help of acceleration power, it means say that rheostic acceleration from reaching O to A, then this is the time taken by the train T1. So there is called rheostatic acceleration. If we increase more supply voltage increase, therefore we reaching A to B, therefore this curve is called acceleration on speed curve. So in this curve time T1 to T2, and if we m more we get speed. When the in case we generally given the constant supply, we get the free running point B to C. So time taking to reach the T3 from T2 is called free running. When time taking T4 from T3 is called costing. In this costing, the power of the motor is cut. And the train is running from by the help of moment inertia, train or vehicle, we can take any example. If when the D to E reach time, it will take T4 to T5 is called braking, or we can also say that retardation. So there are main 5 point: rheostatic acceleration, time taking 0 to T1, acceleration or speed curve, time taking T1 to T2, for free running, time taking T2 to T3, and for costing, it means then power cut off, time taking T3 to T4, and for braking, time taking T4 to T5 is called braking or retardation. So there are the many type of the points is used in speed time curve. First is acceleration, second is speed curve, third is free running, fourth costing, and fifth braking. So we know that according to the railway system or other for other vehicle, all the distance are categorized in three types: urban, suburban, or mainline suburban. Urban mean the train running in city areas. The distance between the station, it's mean that stoppage is very minimum. Suburban is there in suburban area. We know that all the township are include in suburban area, and the long line from the maximum kilometers is called mainline service. So first of talk, we talk about the figure first. Figure first so represent the speed time curve for urban service. Urban service, it means that there is a minimum distance. So train, when train is starting and or it, we can also say that the motor is starting, this take highly acceleration time A to B. After this reach this position B, the power is cut off. So the train is run according to the moment of inertia and reach to C. After nearest to station, the braking is controlling by the motor and reach to the D point. So their curve is very different from the last curve. If we take figure second show that speed time curve from suburban area. In suburban area also distance is very low between the stoppage. So in this system the maximum speed of acceleration is very high. So we see in this curve 0 to A and A to B. After we reaching B, the power is cut off, therefore coasting, and C to D. It means that figure 1 and figure 2 show that if train is running on speed curve, therefore no presence of free running, direct B to coasting. It means that direct acceleration speed on to coasting effect. So see this diagram, B to direct C, coasting, no free running facility in traction system because the stoppage between the station is very few distance. If we take figure third is speed time curve for main line service. It means that the kilometers are very high. So we take all the proper system, first acceleration and their speed curve and their free running and coasting and braking. So there are the all the procedure of use system in the study. So there are the difference between the speed time curve for urban services, speed time curve for suburban services, and speed time curve for main line services. So some terms of use in the speed time curves. First of all, their speeds. Three type of speed used in this system: crest, average, and schedule speed. Crest speed, it means that maximum speed attained by the train during the run. So in this diagram, we show that the Vm is the maximum speed attained. So there are the crest speed. Vm O to Vm is called crest speed. Crest speed means that it is the maximum speed Vm attained by the train during the run. Second is average speed. Average speed means distance between stop, actual time of run. Distance between stop is actual time of run. If we count, there are the speed, average speed. And in this case, the running time is considered only, but not stop time. And the schedule speed is distance between stop and actual time of run plus stop time. So because the schedule speed also depend upon the how many times stop in train at many type of stations. So now we consider about the relationship between principal quantities in trapezoidal diagram. So all the type of areas such as urban, suburban, and main lines, we get curve acceleration, free running generally, and braking. There are the main basic diagram of any traction system, main line traction. We in this diagram we create the trapezoidal shape in this curve. So there is the trapezoidal shape O to A to B, and B to C, and C to E, D to O, E to D, and D to O. From reaching time of O to A, time T1, reaching time from D to E, time T2, and E to C is time T3, and total time is T in second, and speed is kilometer per hour. according to calculation, acceleration is a formula, alpha equals to maximum speed upon time taking. The alpha equals to vm upon t1 from curve. So there is a alpha, vm is a maximum crest speed upon time taking alpha, and retardation is a maximum crest speed vm and time taking t3. Beta equals to vm upon t3, and time t2 is vm maximum speed into time. So there are the formula, alpha equals to vm upon t1, or t1 equals to vm upon alpha, and retardation beta equals to vm upon t3, or t3 equals to vm upon beta. Retardation means braking. We know that the total distance d between the two stop is given by the area of trapezoidal OABC, and d equals to area OABC. So d equals to area OABC, the total trapezoidal area. The total trapezoidal area basically sum of all the distance. The total distance is half vm t1 plus vm t2 plus half vm t3. The, therefore we know that t2 equals to t2, if we want t2, calculate t3 plus t1 and subtract from the t2. So we get, put the value of t2, t minus t1 plus t3. The total time we know that t, so put the value of half vm t1 plus vm t minus t1 plus t3 plus half vm t3. If we common from vm all the equation, t1 by 2 plus t minus t1 minus t3 plus t3 by 2. If and we know that therefore half is common and t is outside of the equation, t minus half t1 plus t3, and put the value of t1 and t2. We know that t1 equals to vm upon alpha and t3 equals to vm upon beta. Therefore, put the value of vm upon alpha and vm upon beta, and 1 by 2 is outside of the equation. So we get equation vm t minus vm upon 2, 1 upon alpha plus 1 upon beta. Let the total term 1 upon alpha plus 1 upon beta into vm by 2 is considered by k. So substitute the value from the we get the above equation from the Dhanacharya formula. Put the value of k, d equals to vm t minus kvm. Put the value d equals to vm t minus kvm. So this is make a quadratic equation, kvm square minus vmt plus d equals to zero. In equation 1, so put the Dhanacharya formula of any quadratic equation is b plus minus minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So we put the value of minus t, so in equation also minus 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 plus t minus minus b plus minus under root b square. B square means t square, so t square minus 4kd upon 2k. So there are the giving the two values, vm equals to t plus minus under root r square minus 4kd upon 2k. So and from equation 1, kvm square equals to vm t minus d, or we can get k equals to 1 upon vm minus d upon vm. Put the value equals to d upon vm square vm t upon dt minus 1. Now we know that distance upon time is total acceleration, so there is a k equals to d upon vm square vm upon vm minus 1. We know that the vm, va and d are given the value of k, and hence alpha and beta can be found for any trapezoidal speed time curve. So there are the most important calculation asking in university exam, and so must be read them. Thank you.